Hi, I'm Tom Tripp, and I am a professor of management and also associate dean of undergraduate programs for the Carson College of Business, and I reside mostly out at the Vancouver campus. How do you provide lots of feedback efficiently and effectively? In terms of writing style, one of the things that's really useful is to have a good rubric. And rubrics are all the rage, and for a good reason. Rubrics, first of all, especially if you give them out to students in advance, which I recommend, it tells them how they're going to be graded, therefore what's important, what quality means in an assignment, and how they need to basically configure their assignment so it meets these rubrics, does well in these rubrics. Then you go through and you read it and you mark up these rubrics, and it's a quick way because all you have to do is circle stuff that you're looking for, and it gives them sort of instant feedback. The other thing that the rubric does is it also convinces students that you're grading consistently, which is important to their belief that you're grading fairly, which is important to them being motivated. So if they believe that you grade unfairly, they don't understand what you're looking for, and they think it's inconsistent, they think it's a crapshoot, then they won't believe anything they do matters, so why try? Another thing that helps provide a lot of feedback quickly, particularly regarding writing style, is so what I do is I have a technical writing handbook that's assigned with the course. And there's lots of different ones out there. The one I have, one of the things I like about it is it has a bunch of entries basically from A to Z. Yeah, so the difference between affect and effect, A versus an, or you get up into the P's and there'll be a long section on proper paragraph structure. And so what I can do is when I go through and I read the writing style and I see effect when it should be affect, rather than, you know, write out the whole word, or if I see a sentence that has a disagreement between the subject and verb, and I have to write disagreement, you know, subject singular, verb plural, I got to stop and have to crib it there in the little lines. My handwriting's kind of terrible, and it takes me a few seconds. So all I do is I circle the word or the passage that's problematic, and I put a page number that refers to the page number in the handbook, and they have to go look it up. So what happens is, first of all, this handbook of writing can explain the concept much better than I ever could, particularly even better than crib into the margins. Of course, you have to make them go there. So they have to revise in my classes and to go look at that. And it's really fast.